So it's Wednesday, right? Hello. You guys having fun so far? Are you guys as tired as I am? Good, as long as it's not just me. So today there's no keynote because we did the professional breakfast this morning. We did that so we could free up an evening for moths, but we'll talk more about that later. But we've got some housekeeping stuff we need to do before we can start the day. So welcome to Winnipeg. Today is the first day of the main conference. So now we fall into the standard, you know. There'll be six simultaneous talks. You'll have to pick between them. You might need a time machine. Good luck with that. And it must be time for a giveaway. Now today's giveaway is a lie. It's one of the tablets we're using for registration. So what you... That's right, you win a slightly used tablet. We're very sure it works now. So what you win is the promise of a future tablet. And I have some names here. Is Russell Jorgensen in the room?
Yeah.
Wow, it's like 3 for 3 now. Could you go and talk to Rego later in the day and convince them that you want a tablet and try and trick them into getting it? I think this might be the first LCA I've ever been to where every winner has been ready. And we should keep up the good work.
We are all winners, Michael.
Yes, we're all winners, apparently. So I think you've all figured out networking now. I don't think we had any network problems yesterday. I'm told that during yesterday's keynote, even though you were paying attention, right, we did 400 megabit out of this hall. So you need to pay attention a bit more to the keynote the next 2 days, and we'll see that on the network graphs, right? We have our charity raffle. Again, it's the Cystic Fibrosis Association and the Leukemia Foundation. We are now selling raffle tickets. We made nearly $1,000 for these charities yesterday. And once again, the prize is a $700 desktop CNC milling routing machine thing, to use the technical term. So I'd like us to get to 10K if we could, because that's the maximum. And I want to hear them squeal when they hand over the check. So, keep up the good work. I need you to be nice to each other. Now, there's kind of no nice way to say this, and I didn't really want to have to be here, but I paid the big money to do the unpleasant things. Yesterday, we sent a delegate home, specifically for breaching our code of conduct, but the interesting thing is, they were harassing one accommodation vendor's staff to the point where the staff at the accommodation venue no longer felt safe providing them with service. It's our job to look after both our volunteers and our vendors, right? I don't have a choice when this sort of thing happens, so we sent him home. And we're sad it happened, we've dealt with it in private, we don't want to make a big deal about who it was or anything like that, hopefully it's a learning opportunity. But the code of conduct isn't there to like make you guys not have fun or anything, it's for really serious stuff. Employees should always be allowed to finish their job. So that's all I'm really going to say about it, and I'm sad we had to do it. But I kind of like us to move on and not have to do it again if we possibly can. So after this we go to morning tea again, just like the other days, we should be falling into a routine now. It's at the Manning Clark Centre. And like I said, we go into talks. All the talks are in the Manning Clark Centre in those 6 rooms you should have seen by now, if you've actually been coming to the conference. So we're running 6 simultaneous. At this point, I don't think we have any gaps in the program, which is cool. So there should be heaps for you to choose from. And the other thing we want to get done this morning is we want to hand out the Rusty Wrench Award. But this is above my pay grade. So if I could ask Rusty and Mary to come up.
The Rusty Wrench Award is an award for community contributions or community service in the free software community in Australia and New Zealand. It was established because a lot of that work tends to be under-recognised in our community despite Michael's own emphasis on how much work he's doing. Probably he's not giving sufficient emphasis. So it's been awarded four times now. The first time it was awarded to its namesake, Mr. Rusty. It dismantles, so you can for easy transport, and we have a, it is indeed a rusty wrench. It was also awarded to Kimberly Wetherill, who has contributed greatly to the community's position on intellectual property, especially as it relates to Australian laws and international treaties. It was awarded to Peter Waugh, who has done all the things all the time, everywhere. Proud to be the recipient of the 2012 Rusty Wrench Award. I'm very pleased to be here, passing it on to the next great contributor to our community, and I'm pleased that in this community we have an acknowledgement of community contributions, because it's really, really hard work, and a lot of people from outside Australia have complimented Australia on the way that our community actually recognises the core contributions by community organisers in a way that's not typical for the free software community. So I'm proud to be kicking off the awarding of the 2013 Rusty Wrench.
Okay, so we actually take nominations, and then the previous winners all conspire together to ignore them. Decide who's going to get the award. We are lucky that when you scrape the surface, we find a lot of people doing a lot of great, often unrewarding grunt work that builds our community and holds things together. And when we look at the Rusty Wrench, we look at somebody who just dives in and does stuff and has done, when you think, okay, you recognise their name for one particular thing, you dig down, you discover there are about five other things they've done before that that you might not have known about. In this case, the list includes Open Source Victoria, Linux Users Victoria, the Melbourne Linux Conf AU. Now, at this point, you might be getting this hint, a geographic hint about where we're headed. But it also includes an awful lot of advocacy and enthusiasm and passion and a love of open source. Things like Drupal and the dilemma that we're presented with when the person was actually busy organizing DrupalCon, which happens to be coming up very soon and therefore wasn't actually here to exist. But we managed to drag her out anyway. So, Donna, if you would come up on stage, please.
Some of the things. things that I think are really important. Rusty created this event, and I think we can all agree that he has created something incredibly special for the Australian open source, free and open source software community. Please give him a massive round of applause.
Now, Donna, we have some sticky tape here if you need it. So I think the other thing I should say in the context of all of that is... Ooh, big blue screen. Pia isn't here because she's personally responsible for TBL coming to the conference. And part of that is TBL is going around Australia and New Zealand talking. And she has to handhold that whole process, which is this hilariously complicated giant thing she did just to get us a keynote. So that's an amazing contribution to LCA 2030 itself. Although it's also a good chance to say, if you do want to come to the keynote on Friday, perhaps you should be a little bit early. I know the theatre feels a bit empty now, but there'll be about 1,200 people here on Friday. So perhaps being 10 minutes early might be a good idea. Now, I'm pretty sure my laptop having gone to sleep, but that's all we've got for you.
Box.
Oh, no, you're right, I have a box, I've got to wait for it. Aha. So the reason we moved the professional delegates session is because we wanted to provide more time for moths. We'll have the whole of the Manning Clark Centre open until 9:30 tonight. I know that all of the slots in theatres are taken, but you know what, moths can be whatever you want. If you want to meet in a corner of the lobby or a nearby coffee shop or bar, or whatever, that's cool too. So you know, don't feel constrained by all of the rooms having been taken. If you want to get together and chat about whatever you guys work on, then that's completely cool. You can see the list of the BOFs on the wiki, and one day when I get more than 5 minutes to sit down at my computer, I'll get it onto the Zoom schedule as well. Now, that's the end of what we've got organised for this morning. I think we're running a little bit early though. Any changes?
No.
Well, we're running about 15 minutes early. Shall I just, waste 15 minutes, or do you want to go to morning GO? You've already said that.
AGM tonight.
Oh, no, good point. So, Linux Australia voting closed at midnight last night, this morning, depending on how you think about it, I suppose. The AGM is tonight. It's on the schedule. It doesn't conflict with anything else on the schedule, so that you have no excuse to not come along. I think we're going to see a bit of a change in the board because there's a few people who are going to take a break. So if you had AGM to go to, then now's going to be a good one. So yeah, don't forget the AGM as well. Shout out to people at the front, is there anything else I've forgotten?
Where's
the AGM? It's in the Manning Clark Centre in a room. I don't remember which one.
Two,
apparently. Manning Clark 2. But if that's not big enough, we'll spill over. But we'll see if I'm not. Anything else? People who tell me what to do? Cool. Alright, well, why don't you get